Bonjour, my friends. I'm Frankie. Welcome to Club Food. There are so many recipes that need a side to accompany them. Besides veggies, there are other side dishes such as rice and pasta. There's a meal that I like to serve with pasta, and it is my veal ossobuco. Here's the recipe. In today's episode, I'll show you how to make my orzo a la milanese. The creamy texture of this side dish is just fabulous. With a beautiful saffron scent in the background, this recipe goes very well with ossobuco, pork roast, and chicken. This is a fabulous change from traditional risotto made with arborio rice. So my friends, let's get cooking. In a small bowl, we'll combine dry white wine with saffron threads. We'll let it sit for 10 minutes while we start the pasta. First, in a medium pot, we'll pour in the chicken broth and keep it warm during the entire time. We don't want to simmer it, so medium-low heat should be fine. If you see the broth starting to simmer, remove it from the burner and lower the heat. Next, in another medium pot over medium heat, we'll add oil and butter. When it's hot and the butter has melted, we'll add the orzo. We'll stir until the pasta is well coated and starts to soften slightly, about a couple minutes. Then we'll pour in the wine mixture and stir until the liquid is completely absorbed. We'll add about half a cup of the warm chicken broth and stir until the liquid is totally absorbed, and we'll continue ladling half a cup at a time, making sure the liquid is absorbed between each addition. That's the key for a nice creamy texture. The entire process might take about 30 minutes. We'll season the risotto with freshly ground black pepper, ground sea salt, and some Parmigiano Reggiano cheese. We'll stir once again before serving it immediately. And my friends, this is our orzo a la milanese, a great risotto substitute from the traditional rice. This pasta is a flavorful change. Deliciously creamy, this tasty, unctuous orzo risotto is an incredible side dish. With a nice perfume of saffron, you and your guests will be delighted with the flavor and texture of this beautiful recipe. I hope you give it a try soon, and be sure to visit clubfoodie.com for ingredient a month and more info. Until next time, my friends, bon appétit!